In this demonstration, I'm going to use MATLAB Coder to generate production C++ code from a MATLAB algorithm. We've made a number of recent improvements to our C++ code generation that I'll be highlighting. The example I'll be using represents an oscillating system using two MATLAB classes inside of a package called MySystem. We'll be using the MATLAB Coder app to generate C++ classes from these MATLAB classes. Everything I'm showing can also be done using the cogen command on the command line. Our entry point function is called effective damping, and to tell MATLAB Coder what the input types to this function are, we can use our test script run effective damping to automatically find those. Next, let's reuse that same test script to check for the absence of any runtime errors before we generate code. I'll choose to generate a DLL to share with my colleagues and say I want C++ code. New in R2019B is this option called Interface Style that lets you choose between generating free functions or a class with methods. We'll choose Methods and give our interface class the name Oscillator Interface. Let's open the MATLAB Coder report to explore the generated code. On the left, we see the input MATLAB files and the generated C++ files. Here, our interface class is exported from the DLL and has the name we specified. It has a constructor and destructor, and our entry point function was added as a public method. Any MATLAB state like persistent or global variables will show up as properties in this class to make the code multi-instance. New in R2020A, MATLAB classes are mapped to C++ classes in the generated code, and R2020B adds the ability to map MATLAB packages to C++ namespaces, like we see here. Starting in R2020A, the generated code uses the Coder Array class to manage dynamically allocated arrays. It has an interface similar to standard vector, it has operator overloads for indexing, and gives you exception-safe memory deallocation. Now that we've explored our generated code, let's verify its behavior. With Embedded Coder, you can click the Verify button and enable source code debugging. The generated code is launched in a separate process, inputs are passed from MATLAB to that process, and your platform IDE like Visual Studio is attached to it for debugging. Breakpoints are automatically set for you inside the interface constructor and your entry point methods. And from here, you can step through the generated code just like any other C++. Once we're happy with the behavior of our generated code, we can package up the code and its dependencies into a zip file to share with our colleagues. In the future, if you'd like to move from an app-based workflow to a command line workflow to support systems like automated build systems, you can click the Convert to Script option. This produces a MATLAB script that recreates all of the code generation settings in your MATLAB Coder project. We've been continually improving MATLAB Coder. Since R2019B, we've added support for numerous MATLAB capabilities, including table and date time, machine learning and deep learning, and code generation support for many signal processing toolbox functions. We strive to generate fast code that approaches or even exceeds hand code. If you're interested in C++ code generation from MATLAB Code, I suggest taking a look at the new C++ capabilities in MATLAB Coder for 2020B. Taken together, they allow for the generation of idiomatic and exception-safe C++ code from your MATLAB algorithms. The example I've used here is available in our documentation. Thank you for watching.